fire, fire. Her name is Rita Chigozi. She had gone hiatus for about 9 or 8 years, but she is back with a bang. She is actually a hair hostess. She was very active back in the day. She did songs with people like Henry Tigan. I remember her doing a song with, there's another one that he did with this guy who passed on, Dennis Rackler, among other records. And that is a comeback song titled Fire Fire. In case you just tuned in, you are rocking with the best. Now, of course, she's not best in Uganda, and on set, I'm joined by another brand new talented artist. She's also not best in Uganda. I know you are best in Denmark. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
How are you doing?
I'm doing great.
You're doing great?
I'm so happy. I'm so glad to be here.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm so blessed to be live here on NBC.
Okay, on UBC. Yeah. All right, first things first, what's your story? How did you start out?
I started out as a singer-songwriter,
okay,
writing my songs. Mm. I taught myself how to play guitar.
Yeah.
Because before that, I was singing in a gospel choir.
All right.
And I really loved music and everything with music, the creativity. And then I thought I had some things I wanted to get out.
Yeah.
And I always felt free with music, singing. So I taught myself how to play a guitar.
Wow.
And then I began writing songs, and that's 10 years ago. So
I think some people are actually born artists. Because you see, it took me, it took me 8 months learn how to play a trumpet, a trombone, and a number of wind instruments.
Yeah,
That was with the guidance of someone who knew music, you understand?
Yeah.
But it actually surprises me that actually some of you guys, you're like Bruno K, was like he also trained himself.
Yes.
Now you, another live example, you trained yourself how to play a guitar. How hard, how easy was it for you?
It took me 3 months I could actually write a real song out of the chords that I had learned.
You can play all keys.
Only guitar.
You know there are keys. There is
I can play some that are manageable for me to write and get melodies.
Okay.
I get melodies first in my head, then I sit down and try them out on my guitar, and then sit down and write lyrics, and that's how I do it.
All right, what's the title of the song that we are about to check out right now?
The song is called Mpocha.
Yeah. All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's check out some Mpocha from this beautiful lady right here. And when we return, I know there are so many challenges that musicians who are based in the diaspora face when it comes to promoting their craft.
Yeah.
And you're going to be sharing that and how you intend to counter those challenges. Okay?
Yes.
Perfect. Let's check out the video. Let's go.
Nikuli
Woman or Oliver.
Hey! Bounce! Bounce! You already know what time it is. I'm chilling with Mary Nantairo, and of course, that is her latest song, your debut song, your first song, and it's called Akando ya Omukwano. What's the title of the song?
It's called Mpocha.
Mpocha.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, this is your first song, right?
Yeah.
I understand you could be having some friends who are musicians based in Denmark or based in whichever country.
Yeah.
And I know, I'm sure they have shared with you some of the challenges that they go through when it comes to promoting.
This is like my first song with a video, but I've done other songs before that one.
Okay.
But it's my first song to premiere here on UBC. And
with a video.
Yeah, with a video. Yeah.
So how hard or how easy has it been for you to promote your brand now that even without the videos, you've been having some music on the side, right?
Yeah.
So how hard or how easy has it been for you to maneuver?
It's a very tough job, and I've been doing a lot of promotion myself before even getting here.
Yeah.
So I've been doing very hard work, like promoting myself on social media and sharing my music and doing so many concerts in Denmark.
Yeah.
I've not yet performed in other countries, but I'm going to perform here in Uganda too.
Okay.
So I'm so excited for that, for the very first time.
How is your music received in Denmark? I understand maybe they might not really even understand Uganda, the message, but music being a language of its own, how is it received that side?
People really love my music in Denmark, also because it's love, and I put in even some English words.
Okay.
And they really love something different.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I bring something different there, and of course I always hear I have a very nice voice, and they love when I sing and perform.
Yeah.
So I've really had a very positive vibe from all the people I meet with my music, and that gives me a lot of energy to really focus and continue.
From how you sound, you're this kind of person with this calm demeanor. I don't know, you, the energy, where the energy comes from when you're on stage.
I've heard that before. I'm a very calm person when you get to know me, and I'm really very open as well, and people may think I'm shy,
but
I'm really not shy.
How is the life in Denmark? How is the life in Denmark?
Life,
sorry, for you, maybe even other Ugandans that side.
Yeah, I know a lot of artists are struggling in Denmark.
Yeah.
Music artists from Uganda, even other countries.
Yeah.
And because of that diversity, it gives a lot of challenges, but it's also a positive thing, because then you have to really search for your audience.
Okay.
You can't just put your music out there to anyone. You have to really do a background check on who your audience is before you bring it out to people. Yeah.
All right, Mary, now your final remarks and message to the Ugandan out there who is watching you. They have loved the video and they would want to be your fan. And how do they get to connect with you in 1 minute? Look at the camera right there.
Thank you so much for following me and for liking my music and my video. I'm so blessed to be here. You can follow my music and me on Facebook, on social medias, and of course YouTube. I have a lot of music there. Mary Nantairo is my name, and I'm under the management of Dupias Management. You can also contact them for more information about me and my music. Yeah.
Dupias.
Yeah.
Hey, what a name.
Yeah, it is. It sounds.
All right. But hey, we wish you all the very best in your music. Yeah.
Thank you.
And we got your back here.
Thank you so much.
You bring it through. Yeah, we'll do an interview here and there and promote and see how things go.
Yeah.
You know?
Thank you.
All right. On that note, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, we're going to take a short commercial break. But also, apart from the commercials, we're going to play you a sneak peek of what you missed on Saturday and what you should anticipate for this Saturday on the funkiest and freshest show with a live audience. Right after that, we shall be, of course, returning with your fashion and style update with Linda Dane. Keep it UBC. Thank you so much.